This week I've got Yesterday, which is continuing our kind of year of music-related films. We had Bohemian Rhapsody and Rocketman, and now Yesterday features the music of the Beatles. It's not a biopic. In fact, it's very far from a biopic. The premise of it is, and this is all in the previews and descriptions and everything like that, is what would happen if you were the only one who remembered the Beatles' music? So it stars Himesh Patel's character named Jack, Lily James's character named Ellie. It has Ed Sheeran, Kate McKinnon, Joel Fry, James Corden, and Alexander Arnold. And it's directed by Danny Boyle, who I would call Yesterday kind of a more romantic comedy. And Danny Boyle is not necessarily who I would associate with that. You know, he directed Trainspotting and Steve Jobs and 127 Hours and Slumdog Millionaire. Not the most romantic or comedic movies, depending on your sense of... Oh, and 28 Days Later, the funniest of fun... No. But it is written by Richard Curtis. And Richard Curtis, I would call sort of the king of especially the British rom-com. He wrote Four Weddings and a Funeral, Notting Hill, Bridget Jones' Diary, the screenplay. And he's the writer-director of Love Actually, which is one of my favorite movies of all time. So it's a good combo, I think. They're both very talented on their own. The challenge is I feel like some of it's a little bit antiquated, right? So the idea is that Ellie, Lily James's character, has an unrequited crush on Himesh Patel. He's a struggling singer-songwriter. I mean, the main idea, of course, is that what would you do if you were the only one who remembered the Beatles? You know, would you claim their music as your own? Would you, like, not do anything with it? Would you just, like, feel like you're going crazy? That's the main storyline. But, of course, their relationship is kind of a navigating force of part of this because she was his manager. You know, managers being generous, really best friend and supporter. Their expectations of each other in terms of what relationships need to be is a little frustrating and, again, a little antiquated. And I think that was my biggest bone to pick with this movie. Like, I like the premise of it, right? Like, I like the idea of what would happen if you, you know, woke up in this dystopian, not actually dystopian, but, you know, world that was so different from the one that you knew before. What do you do with this information? Like, do you abuse this power? Are these songs so great, actually, or was it like a lightning in a bottle moment, right? And I thought the movie does a good job of exploring all of those parts. There are actually some very funny moments that are a byproduct of it. Also, shout out to Ed Sheeran. Ed Sheeran was super funny in this. Like, Ed Sheeran played such a bizarre version of himself. Or maybe he played himself. I don't know. Don't know Ed Sheeran. But I thought he was, like, he did a really good job of taking the piss out of himself, which is a British phrase, apparently. I thought, again, everyone did a good job with what they had. Kate McKinnon plays Ed Sheeran's manager, and then eventually Jack's possible manager, and she goes, like, super Hollywood crazy, blah, blah, blah. You know, it's fine. It's fun. It's a nice summer movie. I don't think it's going to be revolutionary. Hey, you say you want a revolution? See what I did there. But it's a cute movie this weekend. You know, the only other thing opening this weekend is Annabelle Comes Home, which looked terrifying, and I'm not willing to see. Sorry, but not sorry. And so, yeah, I think it's a cute, sweet summer film that will possibly disappear into the annals of history. You will listen to a lot of Beatles afterwards, probably, which was, you know, a fun kind of like reliving. I was like, oh yeah, of course I love the Beatles. Like, and I love their extended catalog, not just the kind of like hits. And so I kind of went back and was like listening to them on the way home and after seeing the film. And so it gives you that. I think it's very respectful towards them. You know, they had to get the song rights and it requires a bunch of sign-offs. So it's cute. It's fun. It's a light summer flick. Worth seeing if you feel like seeing a movie this weekend. I'm going to give it 3.3 out of 5.